Hey, brothers and sisters, this is Brother Patrick here in the Philippines. I'm trying to get a different shot. Maybe some of you who watch the videos of the feedings, it's Pastor Raul and his wife, Pastora Daisy, or Sister Daisy. They're here visiting me here in Davao because we're, you know, the Lord has really led me to expand Joshua's ministry. And we've been talking about the different things that the Lord has given us to do. And, you know, we've been doing so much with the small children, with the feedings, which we want to keep expanding that also. But we're talking about the teenagers, the young people. And they've already been doing some work with the young people. But, you know, their church, they need new instruments and stuff. So we're praying about that. I ask you to pray about that. And if you guys who are regular viewers of my videos, you know that the Lord has led me that we will keep adding, making new orphanages. And I've been praying for them to one day do an orphanage, because really the fruit of their ministry is lots of children. The Lord uses them a lot with children and young people. So I know the Lord has a leading in my heart, and them also, to be the house mom and dad of the third orphanage that we will make. So I ask you guys to pray about that. I'm asking for the prayer warriors to pray that, because we have a few, well, we have lots of locations that need orphanages, but we just want to do, you know, do them in the order that the Lord would have us. So I ask you to pray also where we should do the orphanage. The Lord would give us the wisdom, you know, and how soon to start it, now or in a few months or at the end of the year or what. I'm believing and knowing the Lord wants us to do it before the end of the year, so that's what I'm praying about. So anyway, they're here visiting, and we're talking about all those things and expanding the feedings. As you guys know, we've already been expanding and adding new feedings. And so they're here with me. I just let them say hello. Or
hello, brothers and sisters. Thank you very much for sending help or money for our feeding ministry here in the Philippines. Thanks the Lord also for having that one.
Okay, so thank you. You heard from them yourselves. I know you've been seeing them in 1,000 pictures. You know, they're doing most of the feedings, and then their children, they have grown children, and their husbands and wives who are also involved in the ministry. So the other people in the pictures are their grown son and a grown daughter, two grown daughters. And they have one daughter who I asked you to pray for her too. She's about 18 years old or 19. We're maybe we're praying that the Lord will lead her to marry a Christian man, you know, in this the timing of the Lord, that she will. We all know that for teenagers, young people, when they first become adults, it's so hard for them to stay in the Lord. It's so tempting and so easy to backslide. So thank the Lord their children are, none of their children are backsliders. And we pray that to help them, that they will find Christian husbands and wives. And the Lord will make a way for their family. And they've been doing a lot of, I've been working with them, met them first time really December 2005. Been working with them since 2006. Just like the house mom and dad there, Rowana and Ishu in Padada. Known them all that time. And it's very hard, brothers and sisters, to find good laborers. As the Lord commanded us, you know, the harvest is plentiful, but the laborers are few. Therefore, pray that the Lord of the harvest would send laborers into the harvest. So, brothers and sisters, that's the hardest thing for me as a missionary in the Philippines, is finding good and faithful servants of the Lord. And so, when I do find some, by the grace of God, I want to work with them, because there's so many ministries that are, you know, not really doing the Lord's will. They're building their own kingdom, you know, all of those things, like in America too. And so the laborers are few and far between. And so, brothers and sisters, I ask you to pray for Pastor Raul and Sister Daisy, for them to be blessed with health, wealth, wisdom, yeah, peace, joy, and love. All the blessings of the Lord to overtake them and their family, because they have all of their children are starting, you know, even their younger children, by the grace of God, are called to serve the Lord. And I ask you guys to pray for them. And I really sincerely ask you for blessings to overtake them, for the instruments for the Friday night young people's crusades we're going to start doing every Friday night by the grace of God. I've been wanting to do that for a long time, a weekly young people's gathering, you know, and even the young people that come to the Christian concert, it's sowing seeds. You know, they're not out drinking. They're not out getting in trouble. They're at least doing something constructive. And all the young people want to learn to play the instruments. So we can, you know, it gives them hobbies. It gives them something to do and a purpose and a meaning. Because in the Philippines, brothers and sisters, the unemployment rate is probably at least 50 or 70%. And the young people don't have anything to do but drink and get in trouble. So just the opportunity of them to try to practice playing the instrument and learning a Christian song is already a huge, huge thing to bring about the new leaders. Brothers and sisters, we need laborers. And the young people are the labor pool. And we need to get them before the devil gets them. So brothers and sisters, I thank you for your prayers and your support to expand the feedings, the young people crusades, and then another orphanage. And I thank you so much, brothers and sisters. God bless. You know, I love all you guys. I'm praying for all you guys who asked me to. God bless. I'll see you next time.